Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to episode 29. They two have switched room. Episode 29 of the Bears Corner. My missy actually just went to get a wee gin there for the pod, and my missy says to me, "This is becoming a fucking ridiculous habit for you, drinking too much." And I says, "I only drink when the Rangers win, and this season I've turned into a raging alcoholic."
Mate, you should have said, mate, you should have said, "I need to stop you there. It's a requirement." It's not a fucking
you don't
habit,
go on the pod unless.
Correct.
It's a prerequisite to a podcast. You have to have a drink in your hands.
You have to have a drink in your hands. Smashing. Well, joining me this evening for this fine, another celebration pod. That's what it is. It's another celebration pod. We're celebrating like fuck again. You know what I mean? Mr. Paul, it's ease. Paul, how are we doing, mate?
I'm not too bad, thanks. I'm pretty delighted with the way things have turned out so far.
Good, good, good. I'm not sure if we have Derek because it's dropping in and out, but Derek, are we there, mate? Good to see you.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah. I can hear you, but I can't see you, mate. It says coming up saying camera not available.
We detect your camera.
we'll come back to you, mate. Snagsy, how we doing, mate?
I'm having issues here, lads. Bear with me. Carry on.
Okay, mate.
All right, cheers, dude.
Sorry, Snagsy, what was that, mate?
I was singing them. I was, "Hey, you with the sad face, come back to my place and live it up."
By the way, do you know I started that to get it to Christmas number one?
I think you'll find it was me.
Oh, is it you, mate? Sorry.
It was me. Wait a fucking minute here.
Snagsy's actually got a better voice than Elvis.
Elvis is dead.
Exactly.
Thanks, policies. Fuck you.
Love you, buddy. Love you. Love you.
And you.
Before we start, I've been really, really lazy, guys, and my mic is in one of the cupboards in there, and I can't be asking them to get it after the back of a great victory. I just wanted a gin. So this sounds like I'm some sort of pilot for a plane. Apologise. It's just for the earlier pod and the day's pod.
As opposed
I'm
to
going to get the other one. I'm sorry.
A pilot for a plane. What's a what else? Pilot for a fucking ship.
You get ship's pilots, but they don't fly.
A fucking dinosaur. Are you a boat driver or whatever one of them is?
A boat driver.
By the way, I think Kenny's onto something here. I think Derek's done a runner after convincing his auto back Bolton in the old coup last week.
That's top comedy, that, without even trying that camera not available shit, I'm telling you.
He's having a wee bit of issues tonight, but I'm sure he'll come back.
Technical issues.
Anyway, on to the night. Group winners, lads. Still undefeated this season. Wow. Stevie G's Rangers are absolutely motoring. And it's. I seen somebody say the day on Twitter, would you take us winning the title at a canter or winning it on a last day thing? No. Let's win it as soon as possible.
My heart won't take it.
No, Policies will be away. Derek, we're back. Somebody's found out you're on a Rangers pod, mate, and they've cut your fucking internet, dirty bastard.
I'm having
it's all right, mate. It's all right. take your time. The Mosney corner has moved. You're right, Mark. And that was copyrighted by Snags earlier, so you can't say anywhere you'll get me in the courts here.
It doesn't fucking follow me, mate. It never follows me. I made it, just like that fucking tune that's at number one.
who said actually a really, really good point there? Yes. Stephen Gerrard. Again. We seem to be toasting him every week, man. Man's a fucking legend.
Can you put that comment up again for me, please?
Yes.
I just want to point something out there, because Stephen Gerrard and his staff have done at the Battle Fever podcast.
I think, and the job.
Thanks, Stephen. Thanks for joining us on the podcast.
That's
making
why
it happen.
That's why we're so well organised in this podcast. As you can see, camera not available. So I don't need Gerrard's preparation.
that's a secret hidden pod that will only be brought out once the league title is confirmed.
The fact of the matter is, Paul, it says you can only have three up top.
That is correct. Right, getting to the game this evening. Left Poznan 0, Rangers 2. We started with McLaughlin. Nathan Patterson came in for Captain Tav. Then we had Conor Goldson, Leon Balogun, Borna Barisic, Bungani, Zungu, Scotty Arfield, Glenn Kamara, who was tremendous again. Yanis Hadji, Cedric Eaton, and Joe Rebo. Paul, were we, obviously the pod got its absolutely bang on, mate, for our predictions in the pre-match pod. were you surprised at any of that?
No, not at all. I said we predicted the team from the start. We even predicted the correct substitutes, including the young goalkeeper Kinnear. We nailed that one as well. Fucking hell, man! Could we have been more wrong in our prediction early on? Jesus, seven changes though, and I think it's testament to our strength and depth that we have now. We could make seven changes and still basically walk that game, barely getting out of third gear. That is. I mean, if you'd have said that last season, you'd have gone, aye, right. You know, looking at the bench stuff I had last season. But no, I think we are streets ahead of what we used to be. And it was great to see some of the changes. I mean, I thought, as you said, Kamara was outstanding. I mean, I love the way he just drops that shoulder.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? And he leaves his marker completely in no man's land. Where the hell is he going? Yeah. I thought Cedric Eaton played a fantastic game. He led the line really, really well. And he took his goal really well and all. I mean, I thought even when you went to shoot, watching the halftime thing, when McCoy was talking, I was thinking, drive it low and hard across the keeper. You know what I mean? But no, he didn't. High and right. And that was just, caught the keeper off guard. A great shot. And his little layoff towards Hadji as well. But Hadji just, I don't know, it was running through treacle, I think, to try and get the ball.
If only had a bit of pace.
Yeah, exactly. Aye.
If only I had a half yard shot.
Yeah, but I thought Patterson played pretty well. He's a lot of promise as well. I think you can see a lot of these players were kind of a little bit game rusty. Zungu had a good match. I think he was kind of nullified after his booking. I mean, he booked for slipping.
Absolutely ridiculous, in fact.
Yeah.
Barney says Zungu's yellow was ridiculous. He fell, for fuck's sake. He had a cracking game, was everywhere and soaked up loose balls when he wasn't breaking down their attack. Completely agree.
He wasn't putting his foot in after that the way he was beforehand because he couldn't, but he positioned his body in such a way that the guy who was facing him had to play the ball. He couldn't, you know, he couldn't get around him. It was a very intelligent play from Zungu. I was very, very impressed by him. But no, I thought we'd have the team they put out performed really well. And then when you turn around and, you know, he starts making substitutions, brings on Tav, Barker, you know, Alfie, Kent, Calvin Bassey, you think, Jesus, you know, as I said, strength and depth at last.
Yeah. Snagsy, obviously we said before the game, mate, that we thought we did get this right, that we thought it would be a comfortable night for Rangers and we'd get a victory. Obviously that's proven to be the case. Just shows you though how far we've come, because we can go away from home in Europe, make seven changes and have a comfortable victory in Europe. That's absolutely mad, you know.
Absolutely, mate. And you know, I was a tiny wee bit nervous when I saw how many changes we made, but I thought, no, stick with it, Snags. We know what's going to happen here. We're going to come out the blocks and we're going to be a bit ring rusty. We're going to make a few mistakes and then the chemistry will start to click together and we'll take control of the game. And that's exactly what we did. I felt Bagana Zungu was amazing. He was everywhere on the park, and even despite his booking, I felt he was still strong in and out of possession, and he just knew where to be at the right time. Cedric Eaton's hold up play was sensational. He's got this natural ability, even when he's not in front of the player, to get in front of the player and hold the ball up and play the right pass, or you know, make the correct layoffs and stuff. And it was just absolute joy to watch. And young Nathan Patterson, I think I said on Twitter, you know, he made a few mistakes with some of his passing because he was a bit slow in possession. But actually, some of the cross balls he made were fantastic. And he is he's an outstanding talent. And there's just too many people to mention. But Glenn Kamara, another one that stuck out for me. His pressing play is a thing of beauty. And I would be very surprised if he's a Rangers player next season. He's just amazing. Absolutely amazing. So it was good, and obviously strength and depth. To mirror what Paul Atsiz says, when you see guys like Tav and Morelos and that coming on, you're like, fuck off! You're taking the piss now. You're taking the piss. Put it away, man. Put it back in its box for the next game. Come on. But no,
I know, Derek. I think we've got you back, mate. And just before we come to you for your thoughts on the game, you've got to spare a thought for some of the obsessed ones that watch our podcast, because their team's playing and there's a Rangers podcast on at the same time, and it's kind of, you know, they're kind of clashing. So I hope you've stayed with us, lads, as I know you probably have. Anyway, Derek, your thoughts on the game, mate?
Mm,
Post your mic now.
You're on mute, Sandra. You're on mute.
We'll come back to him. We'll come back to him. I don't know what's happened. You've been papped in that Mosney corner, and Snagsy just filed you to the other side and kept all the problems for you, mate.
He said we were really good. That's what he said.
Oh, hang your back, mate.
Can you hear me?
Aye.
Yay! Yes. A great thanks.
Jesus, man, honestly, having a terrible time here. No, there was another dominant display, wasn't it? I don't think through the course of the campaign so far, I think only even Liège last week, if you felt that the players would work it out amongst themselves and get back in top. I think only the Benfica game over there, when they went in front early on with Hollander's OG, you're thinking to yourself, you could be in for a hiding. But apart from that, I don't think I've ever seen a Rangers team just dismantle teams in Europe on a regular basis. Even, I mean, Walter's team in 2008 when they got to the cup final, we get pumped pretty much every game. It was just a siege mentality, wasn't it? You weren't outplaying these teams, and I don't think I've seen a Rangers team play as well as this, especially this season. I know it's been building up over the last couple of campaigns, but it's exciting times, that's for sure.
Paul, as Derek says there, mate, I mean, even under Advocaat, under Walter, the success we had getting the UEFA Cup final all the years ago, McLeish, it always has been a, right, dig in, let's dig in and we can nick it. I know the teams were playing in the Champions League though on certain occasions as well, and obviously that's a step up. But to actually see a Rangers team go, we went to Benfica, I know, right, they went a man down, but I still believe Rangers would have played the same way that we did. You know, getting on the ball, being brave, trying to play football, trying to score goals. It's incredible to watch just how far Steven Gerrard's took us in that short space of time. You know, this is only his third season.
Yeah, I mean, I say I'm slightly older than you guys. Play older.
Fuck
than all
off.
You. I'm probably older. I'm probably older than all of you put together. I mean, I've been watching Rangers now for 46 years, went to Ibrox, and I have never, ever, ever seen us play so consistently, so bravely, and so in control. Do you know what I mean? Especially in Europe, it's absolutely astonishing to see. And it's somebody who's been through the good and the bad times, like most of us have. But I mean, I've had the bad times, good times, and we're heading back into the good times again. It's just this phenomenal, and I'm loving it. Do you know what I mean? I'm not even worried about matches anymore. You know what I mean? I do have my little superstition that I stick to, you guys know about. But apart from that, you know, it's just like, let's go. Because we can, the way the teams play just now, they're sky high in confidence. But it's not just confidence, it's ability and belief and everything. I don't know what the coaching staff have done to them, but it's just, God, give me some of that. You know what I mean? You've done win a lot.
You could hear again that one of the benefits of the fans not being in Snags is you could, and the commentator said it, Rob McLean, even though he's fucking absolutely depressing. I mean, he describes Cedric Eaton as an unlikely hero. I'm sorry, the boys get back to potential. It might not just have clicked yet, but they gave him a fucking break, man. But they even said about how you could hear the coaching staff going, saying press, press, press whenever they lost the goal.
Yeah.
It's relentless with Jeremy's coaching staff. The minute you lose it, hunt it back in packs.
Aye, absolutely. And do you know, I tweeted about Rob McLean during the match, and I said that he was feeding me depression via a big, massive anti-Rangers spoon through my fucking telly. And I tell you what, mate, I fucking hate listening to that guy. But honestly, what you were saying about, you know, obviously we don't spend too much time chatting about him because his complete fucking repertoire was shite. He had one stat, you know, that's how much effort he made. And Alec Ray stole it halfway through and repeated it again. and then at the end they took it in turns to say the same thing over and over again. I'm just like, shut up. Anyway, so somebody mentioned siege mentality, right? And I'm going to use a castle raid analogy, right? Because you start at the first gate, you've got the battering ram, right? You've got your team of guys hitting the fucking battering ram against the gate whilst the rest of them are getting fiery arrows fucking shot at them whilst they slay everybody so you can get the battering ram free, right? You've got five gates to go, but folk are taking over for other folk and making sure it happens. You get to last gate, everybody's fucked. Get Morelos, Kent on, fucking ram it, because all you've got to do is get through that last gate and then you can put one through the fucking king's legs and then stab the cunt in the throat. The castle is yours. Do you know what I mean? And that's the difference. That is the difference now. You know, we last season we'd have got to the second gate and everyone, oh, I can't fucking push this battering ram anymore, lads. You'll need to go yourself, fucking big fiery arrow through the neck. That's it, game over. Do you know what I mean? But this season, we've got it nailed. We've got it absolutely nailed. Whether it means we have to change formation or we have to change players in and out of position to make it happen, but we're making it happen. And it's right to that last minute where everybody's like, go, go, go. Even if you're struggling, give it your fucking everything and leave it on the pitch, because tonight is exactly what you'll see. You'll see those rewards. You'll win that group. You'll win that extra cash that'll buy you extra fucking soldiers to get you on that battering ram for the next season.
Can I just... I was back, no, it's my, I forgot what I was going to say.
even though Snagsy's on water, that was just supremely, that was amazing analogy, right? That was stunning, man. The analysis you don't get that with Alan McCoy and Chris Sutton. Well, what you get with Chris Sutton is just very, very depressed look, as if he's tears. A beaten man, you know, and tears and things like that. But
Snagsy's drinking Sutton tears, so that's what he's doing.
Mate, Chris Sutton's riding Rob McLean's anti-ranger spoon through my telly. That's what's happening. And his tears are fucking skating along. Deary me.
It's brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Derek, down south, there's Rangers European exploits getting noticed down there, obviously, what you've been doing there. Because, I mean, it's a tremendous run. You only look at Man United, or I don't know what the fuck's going on with them, you know, but they're a huge club down there, and you look at the way they're getting pumped out, you know, aren't you? And the only thing is we kind of get them now, sadly. But do we get much coverage down there?
I think we're getting a bit more coverage now, especially with the European performances and the fact that, I mean, the domestic form has been so good as well. I mean, when I go to games, when I do the Bolton games, the boys I work with and the journalists are like, oh, Rangers are doing well, sort of thing. So it is getting picked up. Of course, I mean, the Premier League dominates down here. They're not interested in, with all due respect, Rangers against Ross County and what have you. They'll maybe watch the Old Firm game, but if there's another game on, like the Manchester Derby or something like that, that takes over. They've got no idea that unless you're living up in the west of Scotland or whatever, and you're aware of the rivalry and what it means up there, then they're not really that interested. But I think the European displays, they're certainly taking a lot more notice of them. And I tell you what, you mentioned in Manchester United, I'd fancy, I don't know if the Rangers can get them in the next round, can they?
Because they'll be seeded the same as us.
We're seeded now.
Get them in the final, that'd be funny.
We're up there now.
Yeah.
Oh, it feels good to be back.
Actually, do you know, that's a lie, Derek. We can get them and we'll see them in Gdansk.
Yeah. Hey, mate, they're not that good to get there, to be fair.
That's actually true, yeah.
What are you talking about, man? Dear me. They'll be fucking watching for outside.
You mentioned the Champions League, Scott. I mean, last night, Michelin drew me Liverpool. I know that game was pretty much a dead rubber as well, but... I mean, Rangers went over there and pumped them as well, you know what I mean? So that gives you a sort of indication of how far Rangers have come, you know what I mean? It's not an easy place to go up there in Denmark, and they're just swatting these teams aside, aren't they?
Yep, 100%. A wee message here. Merry Christmas, Andrew Bluebells. Yes.
Merry Christmas, Rangers. Andrew, my friend. Anyway, good to see you.
It's not actually just after Christmas, we've got an Old Firm game to look forward to as well, which is tremendous.
Buzzing.
I can't wait. It's going to be outstanding, hopefully. Hopefully, but
I tell you what, mate. I tell you what, that random SPFL fixture generator gets that right every single time, eh?
Yeah,
it's mad. It's mad how they can push the fucking back, but yet the new year one they've got, you know, still
crazy. Crazy.
Can I just say something very quickly? Scott sounds like he's in a call center. He looks like it. No,
it's probably destined to end up, mate.
That's better. We can hear you slightly better now. Yeah.
Sorry, listen, I'm not going to get.
Can I talk
right,
about your gas and electricity, sir? Can I talk about your gas and electricity? Can I get the best deal, sir?
My manager's just tapped me on the shoulder and he says I can give you an extra 10% off if you buy the fucking Mills and Boone collection.
Right now.
Kenny Watson says, Derek, go move to the side, you're blocking God.
That's better.
I just love that his head's the same size as his, so like when he fucking gets right in the middle, he's got extra hair. It's brilliant.
It looks like you've got extra hair. Fantastic.
He's getting, he's got God's luscious locks.
You can advertise shampoo. Get yourself a loud look.
By the way, now we're all kind of laughing at Chris Boyd's face every week and stuff. Stuart's just told us about an absolute belter of a comment. Not that we want to talk about them, but that he's had on Sky tonight. boy there on Sky saying Celtic have had more statements than wins this month. We've definitely passed that baton over, haven't we? Definitely. Absolutely. Quality. Moving on, Cedric Keaton's goal, highest of quality, Paul. Absolutely stunning finish. I think we were all the same as McCoist, got across the goalkeeper, but a big man knows better than everybody and fires away in that top bin like that, man. Stunning.
That's why he gets paid something like £150,000 a week by Rangers.
EBTs.
Yeah, it's the EBT section.
But we don't talk about that. Is that extra big Toblerones?
£150,000 in sausage.
John, I'm going to take exception to this comment. That performance tonight has shown how far the team has come, and long may it continue. We fear no one, as Paul said. No, I believe that was Snagsy and I that said that weeks ago.
No, I said it.
Holy. Tell a lie often enough, mate, it becomes a truth, you know what I mean?
You may have said it off air, but I said it on air.
Oh, I believe if we check back podcast, Snagsy, we said it on air.
Fucking hell. Agreed.
Can you believe that guy?
Old joke for Snags, agreed.
It's not a joke, it's how I speak.
the second goal. Big Connor Goldson, you know, a fantastic header, and you think, oh, big man's just been out of the line and then the replay show, big man. No, I'm sorry, it's not your goal. It's Yanis Adji's tapping, an easier goal he'll never ever score. But again, no, the delivery, the quality of Goldson's header, the big man was just, he's a man. I say that during the county game on Sunday, I put it on Twitter. He's a man mountain. He really is, Conor Goldson. So much of success this season. And I say success because we've not won anything yet. But obviously, our good start to the season is Dundee, him, Tav, Balogun or Hollander and Barisic. And then obviously, between the two goalkeepers. That defence is just, you know, it's amazing. It's when you look at the other side and they're letting goals left, right and centre, you see just where our foundation is, Paul. And it's... Yeah. You know, we've probably been critical of the back line over the last couple of years, 3 years maybe, about how poor we've been, but we've certainly rectified it this year.
I agree. I think you cannot have a successful team unless you've got a solid back line. And I don't know what's happened over the last few months, from last season, certainly for the turn of the year, to starting this season. But my God, what a difference. Do you know what I mean? They're really well drilled. They know each other. I think Hollander and both Balogun are very steady influences in that back of that line. And Conor Goldson as well. He's come on leaps and bounds from the last couple of seasons. Tav as well, just fantastic. Barisic is the player we saw playing against us for Osijek. I mean, I remember leaving Ibrox the night we beat them and put them out, Osijek. And they're walking back to my car with my neighbour. And I said to him, I'd love to sign a left back. What a player he is. 2 days later, we did. We thought we were going to. Yeah. But that season, he didn't really go right for him. It was great last season. He's started this season, absolutely flying. I think our back line is completely solid, no matter who you put in there. You take one of them out, there's a good replacement to go in. Hollander, yeah. Balogun, Goldson. You've now got Tav, you've got Patterson, the saving, excellent. You've got Barisic, left back, Bassi who fit in there as well. And I think he fit in the centre defence and left side as well. So yeah. I think we are spoiled for choice. And I would not be Gerrard. He has his team, and we know which is the solid back four. But my God, it's great.
And Derek, we've also been over the years at Rangers, probably minus the last few years, but over the years at Rangers, we've always been lucky in the sense that we've always had two great goalkeepers. You know, even McGregor's first time around, McGregor and Alexander, you know, new this year, you've got McGregor and John McLaughlin. And again, for Steven Gerrard, just to switch them in and out the way he does, and it doesn't affect the team because John McLaughlin really is a number one in his own right. You know, he's just unfortunate that he's got Alan McGregor there ahead of him. But what an absolute, you know, array of talent he's got, even just as two goalkeepers.
Yeah, it's a safe pair of hands, John McLaughlin. I think it was a really smart move bringing him in. You wouldn't, if McGregor's not playing, you don't worry, don't you know who's going to come in, step in at his shoes. You're quite comfortable with McLaughlin in there. So it was a great bit of business bringing him in. I was speaking to a Bradford fan recently about him, and he was up in arms why he was allowed to leave at the time because he was a great player for them. He's a really dependable goalkeeper, isn't he? He's just. I mean, how old is he now? Is he 30, 33 or something like that?
I think McLaughlin is about that, is he not? 32, 33?
32, I think he is, yeah.
You're
still young for a goalkeeper.
You'd probably think when McGregor decides that when the time comes to hang up the gloves, then he'll be the guy. If he stays, of course, he might want. I mean, at that age, I think he's quite happy just being at Rangers, isn't he? So I think he'd be the sort of guy to take over. And then we've got Robbie McCrory as well out on loan. So I think that's the sort of natural progression, isn't it?
Yep. The future is bright, Snags. The future is bright. And seeing young Patterson, as we've already said, seeing, obviously, as Derek mentions, Robbie McCrory out on loan at Livingston. You know, you've had Leon King, you've got McPake, you know, there's so many there that are just chapping the door. Mabudi's been about the team as well now and again, particularly last season, the season before. But, Gerard, this year, if you do get a wee bit of leading, I know we're going to be into the distance here, but you're looking to see some of these young boys. You know, we did it during 9 in a row. You had your Charlie Mathers coming through, he's at the start of it, you had Ian Durant's coming through, etc. We need to try and bleed the next set of Rangers players as well.
Absolutely, aye, and I think it's super important as well to obviously give them that match exposure, because it's all well and good training with the first team, but you know, you don't learn the trade properly unless you get proper match time, and it would be good to see them kind of coming through towards the end of the season, particularly if they are favoured by the backroom staff, because you know, you look to Alan McGregor's questions with the Rangers Youth Development Company this week, and he was saying like guys like Robbie McCrory, you know, he's like super impressed with him. And he does hope that, you know, he gets into the first team, and it's guys like that we should be bleeding in for sure, even if it's a game here, a game there, 20 minutes here, 20 minutes there. Like you say, when we're a couple of goals ahead, give them the chance.
Get used to playing in a winning Rangers team, because that's a different kettle of fish to just playing in a Rangers team, do you know what I mean? A winning Rangers team's totally different. We get through the group, guys, undefeated. We get through the group with 14 points, which is a record for Rangers. Steven Gerrard and his team this year seem to just be breaking records left, right and centre. Clean sheets, etc. I think, what was that? We're 20th or something, whatever it is. Don't know if those count now. It's just wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. What's that, 21?
21st, yeah.
21st, so it's unbelievable, man. Absolutely unbelievable. Who do we want in the next round? Who, if you're sitting there now, Paul, who is your team that you go, right, I want them?
I don't know who we can face.
Ross County.
No, we want something really easy like Celtic if they qualified.
Snagsy.
Probably Milan, something like that. You know what I mean? Something easy. So, I mean, if Celtic can score a couple of goals against them, we'll fucking batter them. Do you know what I'm saying? We'll absolutely fucking batter them.
Do you know what? I would take easy matches as you can get in Europe anyway, all the way to the final.
Well, I've not had any for about 3 seasons, mate. Perceived. You know what I'm saying? I'm not wanting them new.
Should I say perceived easy matches?
Jesus. I think an English team would be good. If can we get? Right. Is there any English teams up for grabs there?
I don't know. Aye, because you've got young boys, Molde, Slavia Prague, we'll not get Benfica, Granada, Real Sociedad, and I think there's more as well, I think, for the night's games. Obviously, I think this is for last night, or for last week, sorry. And then you've got Salzburg dropping out of the Champions League, Olympiakos dropping out of the Champions League, Krasnodar and Dynamo Kiev. So I think that's the basis of the teams that we can get. I don't think we can get any English teams because we're seeded and so are they. So we'll just need to do them in the last 16.
If you're going to get a Champions League team, you'd probably go for Krasnodar, really, wouldn't you? Or even Olympiakos, because they're
travelling really there.
Who's that? Sorry, Derek.
No, it's just the travelling, mate. Krasnodar's right into Russia, isn't it?
Yeah. Olympiakos. If you're going to get a Champions League team, you probably want the Olympiakos. I've seen their Champions League matches. They are woeful.
I take young boys as well. I take young boys. Molde. I think
Molde's going to be here. I think that's who we'll get. By the way, I don't know. I've just got a feeling.
Molde be actually, you know, actually Molde be actually a good tie. It's eminently winnable. Plus, it's minimal travelling distance and time.
But all the teams you rhymed off, you'd fancy your chances against any of them. There's not none of them that stand out, is there?
No.
Chance against anybody now, really, don't we?
What do they know? See you, all the teams, they're sitting there going, and I know you've got your Man United and Spurs and all that, but they're sitting there going, we don't want Rangers. Because Rangers, that's one of the games, as I say, where people maybe fancy their chances against us. But then when we start, see you later, lads. Oh, by the way, we might be able to get Leicester. Is that not right?
Potentially.
That might be. Might be Leicester.
That would be interesting.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
It depends on the result, doesn't it?
Well, actually, I think the best. I just remembered what that was I was going to say, but it's the nicest thing. It's regarding.
No, rewind 20 minutes.
Because this ties in with what we're talking about, you know, nobody wants us. We for the last couple of seasons with Jad, we're kind of hard and fast. We stick rigidly to what system we're going to play, and it doesn't really change. Now we do. We can change it tactically around. We can change formation, which we've never done before in the last couple of seasons. So this season we have. We've changed our system to nullify their system, but still retaining the way we play. And I think that makes it very difficult to play against and very difficult to beat. That's what I was going to say.
Yeah. Yes. So we've kind of covered the draw and who we can get. Obviously, we're sitting there. We're not sitting going, right, I don't want them, and I don't want them, and I don't want them. I think last year with the Bayer Leverkusen draw, I was still thinking, wait, I don't care who we get, but obviously if you had a choice, you would say, right, stay clear of Leverkusen because they are a fucking side, do you know what I mean? But this year, although Leverkusen are still a really good side and they would still obviously, ultimately they're a better team than us given the money they can spend on their players, etc., and the experience that they have. However, I'm not fearing anybody. You know, let's just get the last 32 we're done with. Hopefully we go through and then we can enjoy the last 16 and see what it takes us, guys, because that's the thing. It's a journey now. We've done what we expect. The minimum expectation has been achieved. You know, that we get out of the group. That's where we're at now. We could probably say the minimum expectation probably is getting to the last 16 and maybe going further, going on last season. But certainly what we would definitely expect to achieve is getting out of the group. And I'm delighted that we've done it with minimal fuss. Getting players, getting fringe players as well. Huge experience in European games. That will only benefit them going forward when we inevitably will require them through injuries to main players, etc. And hopefully, as I say, we've got a squad. Well, we know we do have a squad, but hopefully we can go and win these trophies now and really cement ourselves as a great Rangers squad. Because that's, we can sit here and say they're amazing. They're better than the teams we watched under Advocaat, Smith, etc. Until they hold their trophies above their head, they'll never be classed as that, no matter what they do in Europe. You know, that's a bonus. That's the bread and butter stuff. And if they win 55 and... hopefully, I can see he's getting the other two, if the way they're playing, do you know what I mean? Then, yes, they'll then be up there with the greatest Rangers teams that we've ever seen in our lifetimes, anyway. Moving on to the league stuff.
Just finally, what you're talking about, you said Leverkusen, you know, with their spending and their experience. We've just played Benfica twice. Look at their experience. Ten consecutive years in the Champions League. We played them off the park twice.
No, you're right, mate. Yeah. When they
played them last time, Rangers were so out of form, it defies belief when they played them, remember?
Correct.
They were sort of raising their game. They raised their game against Braga, but it wasn't sort of mirroring onto the domestic form. You play them now, it's a different ball game, isn't it?
Yeah,
of course
it
is.
I would take it to win.
I was just going to say, and obviously they're missing some very key players that they had last time around. As well.
Kai Havertz been one.
Aye, he was the main man.
He was a fantastic player. And that shot he had against us earlier, rattled the bar, nearly took the crossbar clean off the fucking post, man.
Aye. Is the boy Bailey still there? I know that Spurs were sniffing about him. Is he still there?
I think he is still there, as I know.
Bailey. Boy.
Aye.
I think he is, yeah.
I think he is still there. Right, domestic action. Last week, 4-0 away to Ross County. That going on, that's how you do it, you know. They can rock down to Glasgow and win 2 at the inferior side of the city. However, when you take on Scotland's Premier Club, then it's a different story. And we go up there, minimal fuss, pumped, see you later. Nice, wasn't it? Nice. No one we expected, but then again, it makes it sweeter when you see the result a few hours later. And you think, this is getting interesting now. Paul, your thoughts on Sunday, mate? Easy peasy.
Well, it was pretty much pedestrian in many respects. You know, I mean, we it was barely our second gear, and we'd done the business. It was kind of a decent little side. Let's not kid ourselves here, but we absolutely dominated them from start to finish. They barely had a shot on target, and it was just easy. It was nice to sit and watch. It was a pleasant Sunday lunchtime. You know,
It was a wee stroll, wasn't it?
It was. I sat there with a late lunch, you know, a late brunch.
A late lunch.
No. Fuck off. Hang on.
I was shelling my prawns watching the television.
One does not prawns. One has langoustines. I was sitting there with something to eat, and it's a nice cup of tea, and I just sat, and it was just, it was lovely and relaxing, and it's really unusual for a Rangers fan to sort of go into a match and just think, nah, it's gonna be a fucking piece of piss, and it literally was. So yeah,
Derek, this is who we were warning you of. ECID evening, folks. Look at that portrait. And Derek, I'm sorry, mate, you're going to end up with whiplash, but she wants you to move your head again.
Hello.
Listen, we get Derek on the pod more for Derek, you know what I mean? No, for his portrait. Like, as staunch as it is.
She'll be asking to pull up Douglas, is it?
In front of you, like that.
Just you talk behind it for that, yeah. I always said pull it off.
Oh dear. I don't think it will be for sale, Mo, but he did tell you who done it on last week's pod, and you could maybe contact them and get you. Derek, who was that again, mate?
Oh, George. I'll find out. Carry on with the show and I'll find out.
Right. Mo, okay. Paul says he'll buy you as a Christmas present. All right.
Did he? That's news.
Agreed. He did.
Snagsy, just because he said it off air, mate, doesn't mean to say it didn't happen.
Exactly. He showed us the fucking receipt and everything. He's got it already.
Get yourself out of that one at seas.
Correct.
You're talking about the early kickoff and all that.
Yes.
It was funny. You see, Jurgen Klopp. Was it last week moaning about playing at 12 after playing the Wednesday and all that? You're thinking, there's Rangers when it's basically much. It's pretty much the same thing. They've just went up and done the business and went back down the road. I don't understand this moaning all the time. You've got a huge squad.
Exactly.
You play the games. You've got ample time to rest up. It's just,
how can I put this to you? The English Premier League are far and above self-belief and self-inflation. They are so far out of their own arses. They are the self-proclaimed best league in the world. No, you're not. You're the most fucking richest league in the world. You're fucking shit. I would rather sit and watch a championship match than Brighton versus fucking West Ham. Go fuck yourselves, EPL.
What's going on?
Jesus Christ.
I don't hear.
Did you say Jurgen Klopp? I thought he said Lurgen Flop.
That's
Scott.
Sorry.
I've just realised, mate, that we did not mention the poo hatch.
Oh, the poo hatch. Yes, that's the poo hatch, mate.
We didn't mention the poo. No, I'm just saying. Like, obviously, they didn't play in the Ross County game, but it would have been funny if he had, to be fair, the big old poo hatch. But no, it was hilarious. But just to come back to the Ross County game, right? Just to bring us back into the present time. I'm going to use that fucking castle analogy again, right? You're going to love this because this is a classic, right? Where it gets to the fucking 83rd minute or whatever it is. Stephen Davis Rabonas the fucking battering ram through all five of the gates, only to find that Jermaine Defoe's nutmegged the fucking king and stabbed him already. Do you know what I mean? That's it. That's the truth of the matter there. The team was fucking relentless and it was delicious. Like, I mean, that Jermaine Defoe goal as well, do you know what I mean? Nutmegging the defender and the keeper just for shits and giggles. Like, what is that? This is a different reality we're watching unfold in front of us and it's beautiful.
We're not a good team.
We're not a very good team. Remember those people last year who said Stephen Davis is gone, his legs are gone, he's not a good player anymore. Stephen Davis Rabona at Ross County in Dingwall.
And they found his man as well, I may add. Do you know what I mean? He wasn't just doing it for a laugh, he fucking found his man.
Oh, it's brilliant. I love it when the right is off. I love it. Meanwhile, of course, we should say that actually Stephen Davis's legs were apparently gone, yet a certain captain in our team could maybe make the Scotland team for the Euros. Come to fuck, man. That's when you have a compliant media. It's wrong. Absolutely wrong.
I think the compliant media is sanity and marbles have gone.
Aye, they don't know what to do now. They're waiting in directive, innit? That's the problem.
They've
lost their track now. going last week, again, as Snagsy says about Jermaine Defoe, 800 appearances. On his 800th appearance, he scored a goal like that. A typical Jermaine Defoe goal, let's face it. He's fucking the master, isn't he, in that 18-yard box. He's so electric in there. Derek, you're never ever surprised when you see Jermaine Defoe come on with 3 minutes to go, with 30 seconds to go, and the boy ends up in the back of the net. That's just Jermaine Defoe.
He's a freak of nature, isn't he? He's a joy to watch. You just wish you maybe had him a couple of seasons before. He was frightening. He's still frightening. You give the boy a chance in the box. Even outside the box, and then more often than not, it's hitting the back of the net. You know what I mean? He's a goal-scoring machine. we're just happy. Just enjoying while he's here. I think he's got... when's his contract up there in the summertime?
Gerardo says that he wouldn't be surprised to see him playing next season, you know, because he still looks, and you say fit, but there's a difference between fit and being sharp. Jermaine Defoe's sharp, you know what I mean? There's totally different there, you know, being match sharp and alive in the box is it's an instinct. You can't teach that, I'm afraid, you know, and that's still as razor sharp as ever, as far as I can see.
I would be surprised if he's offered a position with us.
Even the young strikers coming through, what a guy to learn from. You know what I mean? There's nobody better to learn. And by all accounts, he does help a lot of the young boys. He talks them through like drills and sort of stuff. So absolutely, but priceless to have him around it, not just on the park doing the business, but in the dressing room as well, in the training field.
That's why I said I wouldn't be surprised if he's offered another year's extension. And maybe not get as much game time, but it'll be certainly... more your coaching, we'll put you towards your coaching badges, because as you said, if you're going to learn from somebody, you're going to learn, you want to learn from the best, and Jermaine Defoe is one of the best this country, as in the UK, has ever produced.
Yeah, 100%. Snagsy, I thought the first 20 minutes in Sunday was a wee bit, you know, you were sitting thinking, right, this is, maybe we're sitting here under thinking, as has been on a podcast earlier on. Sitting here under thinking about, obviously, that was us colluding with each other before that. There, see that? That was
no collusion here.
No collusion here. Yeah, think about how it's a familiar trend for last season. You know what I mean? They were very stuffy. They were very compact. It was hard to break down. You've said though about the Baron Rams and going through the gates and keeping going through the gates. That's exactly how it played out on Sunday, because they got that first, and then it turned into the Stephen Davis show. As far as I'm concerned, and he just sat there in the midfield and dictated everything. Every move, just about, and the first goal with the ball through. You mentioned that the ball through, frightening.
Aye, and you know, like, it will take us like 3 or 4 minutes to, you know, get more momentum and figure out the best route forward. Whilst, you know, the players might already know it from their kind of pre-match brief and whatnot, it will still take a bit of time to allow that to bed in during the match. But once it gets going, Once it starts to move and the passes start to get made and the players start making those runs, you find yourself laughing watching it. You're like, how the fuck did that just happen? But it's outstanding. Like, you know, sort of rewinding back to the match tonight, and Joe Aribo and Glenn Kamara, you know, they've both got that kind of natural ability where the ball looks out of reach, but they still manage to get a leg on it. And you're like, how is that physically possible? But fuck it.
Fuck science.
Just for 90 minutes. Love it the rest of the time.
Can't believe Snagsy said fuck science.
That's what the Rangers does to you, mate.
Fuck science.
That's what Rangers does to you. Blue Rangers says, what thing does Snags have around his neck? It looks like some type of pass to a convention, although what type of convention would he be involved in? And Bob has said probably a gardening convention.
It's the fucking UEFA Europa League best plants, mate. That's what it is. Fucking hell. I was there with fucking Morelos showing off my dahlias, you know what I mean? They're still going because it's no the frost yet. What's wrong with you cunts, man? Jesus Christ.
Snags, tell them the story about the lanyard.
And don't forget to mention the punch.
It's from... don't you fucking dare go there. I made a wee donation to a very popular soldiers charity in exchange for this, and it was very kindly given to me by Andrew Halliday. And I've got the wee Europa League king signed and all that from him. So thank you very much, Andrew. It's lovely. And I like to get it out every now and again just to remind myself what it feels like to be a winner.
Yes. Yes. Barney summed up Snags's analysis there of fuck science, it's biomechanics.
What is this? There's been so many references to the other side of Glasgow tonight. I'm not comfortable with that, by the way. I'm not comfortable with that. Get that punditry to fuck. This is a professional podcast here.
You're right, mate. You are right.
Biomechanics out the window, battering rams in. Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah. If you're not getting killed by fiery arrows by the end of this podcast, you're no welcome.
Wait. You're not going out and battering Dune gates after we've finished here, then you've not done it right, man.
Get under that shield.
if you're not smothered in hot tar, the night's been wasted.
Oh, fucking hell, man. RZN, Hadji is the best. He or she is well hang on with Hadji. Easy peasy, and we roll on to, well, obviously, the other results that weekend mean that Rangers now sit 13 points clear at the top, which is a nice cushion to have. Okay, our team have two games in hand on us, so the least that we can be is 7 clear, which I think at this stage of the season we would all have took anyway. You know, we obviously play first on Sunday against Dundee United, and it's an opportunity to stretch that lead to 16 and put a wee bit of pressure on. So, well, see, Dundee United, they are riddled with Sev COVID, as we alluded to earlier, that Jimmy Bell has been spreading to every single club before we play them. Allegedly. And Jimmy, your efforts are unbelievable, mate, and thank you very much for that, because you're paving the way to 55.
We applaud you, Agent Bell.
It's not quite, you know, it's probably Agent McCulloch, to be fair, up there. No, he's went to Hearts now, isn't he? He's went to Hearts now. Agent McCulloch. Your thoughts, mate, ahead of Sunday. Dundee United, always been a tricky venue for us to go to.
It has been. I had a brief think about this yesterday, I think it was, but not today. I've been so busy concentrating the match and other things with work and stuff like that. I think it will be a relatively tricky match. Even if they have got a lot of players out, it's always been a tricky place for us to go, Tannadice. However, the way we're playing, I've got utter faith. I mean, it's just belief that we are just going to absolutely blow them off the park.
I like teams. Yes. Yeah. Yes. See, just going back to us, he's from Romania. That makes sense now.
Ah, yes, hello.
Hello. Giannis Hadji.
And thank you for tuning in.
Yeah, yes.
Legend. Kenny, who we've had on the pod, this sums it up. Evening, lads. Going to put it simply, we're just a bloody good side, smashing to watch, full of confidence. It's just glorious. We as a club and support deserve this. I agree with you 100%.
Yep.
100%.
After everything that we have been through since 2012, you know what I mean? I think this is just amazing to see. Do you know what I mean? Yeah. We're not going to talk about them across the city, but imagine them going through what we've been through. Fucking hell.
Stop it.
Derek, would a treble make up for the hurt for 2012? I know I'm getting ahead of myself, but...
I think, yeah, it would make it all worthwhile, I think. And we're talking about trebles now, aren't we? Before, yeah. I think a few weeks ago, it was a bad word. You don't talk about that sort of stuff. But seeing what's happening elsewhere, how Rangers are playing, you're thinking, who's going to stop them? Who's out there that can stop them playing like this? And I think the only team that can stop them is themselves. If they suddenly maybe hit a bad patch, or if, touch wood, they don't get any players. I know Hellander's out with coronavirus, but they don't have a spate of that, which might decimate the squad. So I think that's the only thing that's going to stop this team, really. I can't see any team beating them. Even picking up draws. I know Livingston and Hibs earlier on in the season was a little bit iffy, and you think to yourself, oh, we've seen this movie before, but they've picked up from then on and just steamroller teams. So I think a treble is very, very much on.
Snagsy, I think Hellander picked up COVID because he was just unfortunately in the same vicinity as Jimmy Bell for too long, and that kind of backfired on us a wee bit. So obviously Jimmy's he's went away and learned the COVID strategy again, mate. And that's, hello from Cape Town. Our supporters club is just buzzing. What are we on to with the full supporters club? Because that's cool.
That is cool.
That is really cool, if that's the case.
Let us know if the full supporters club is watching it, or if it's just you.
Aye.
But thank you for watching. Brilliant.
We're no jealous that you can get any pubs around like that.
Yeah.
I'm jealous at all about that.
Absolutely,
you know?
Not. Absolutely.
Enjoy not. Your pint.
You bastards.
You boys are still in, is it tier 4 or something?
Aye, until Friday. Until Friday, I think it is.
Pubs open, they can't sell alcohol or something?
Nope.
Yes. But they can now play music, even though they can't open yet.
she announced today that pubs can play music in the background quietly. But people are going, yeah, but they're not open. So, yeah, but it doesn't matter. But when they do, you can play music quietly.
And we'll all whisper simply the best in the Rangers pubs. Snagsy, do you see Dundee United causing us any troubles, mate?
No. And do you know what I think will happen? I think the game will get called off and we'll win 3-0.
There you go.
Imagine.
Sorry, Snags. The whole lot of us. How many is that, Robert?
Please let us know. That'd be fantastic.
Whereabouts are you in Cape Town?
Because I've got friends who live there.
You're when watching those through the one account, obviously, so we need to add all the oyes to our numbers and our family here.
I wonder if you can still get Castle Beer in Africa. Because when we used to go to the Ascension Islands when I was in the RAF, right? You used to get this Castle Beer and there was another one. I can't remember what it was called, but you always hoped that the fridge was full of the other one. Because if you had Castle Beer, you'd go to bed and start like tripping, like fucking magic mushroom dreams. I'm not even joking. You're like big elephants chasing you and stuff.
Yeah. You go to a pub in South Africa and you say something, and Cape Town especially, what do you want to drink? And they go ABC. ABC? Anything but Castle.
crazy shit, man.
Windhoek was amazing. So smooth, clear, but fucking hell, man. You get drunk from feet up. It's like Billy Connolly.
Castle Beer is still here. There you go.
What a shame. That's a travesty.
Robert, for you. I've been looking for an excuse to play this again. So for you, this is it. You're a good soldier, choosing your battle. Pick yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over. The pressure's on, you feel it. This is Africa. Oh, love that tune. I love that tune. Any excuse.
Sung by a South American.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, it's there again, man.
She's hot, mind.
Africa watching.
Say again, sorry?
Is we used twerking there again?
I was twerking, mate. I love a wee dance, me.
Yeah. I have been known to occasionally.
Don't get Snags on your castles again.
Mate, battering rams whilst trying to take a castle, drinking castle is not recommended. You'll end up fucking tying your arms in knots and shit.
That's brilliant. That's absolutely brilliant.
I was just to Robert Cameron and the rest of the crew down there, thank you for tuning in. We really appreciate it.
And everyone else, policies. Fucking
and everybody else. But,
Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Sorry to everybody else.
Snags. We'll edit that bit out. It's okay.
So, Paul, we're live. Sorry to be moaning all that. You know who watch every week. Sorry.
Aye. Never mind them. South Africa's calling.
Nul poids.
Oh, mad. Absolutely mad. So, anyway, Dundee United is what I was saying. Sorry, Snagsy, I cut you off, mate. You see it getting called off in a 3-0 victory awarded to the Rangers.
Mate, they were all covered in Jimmy Bell's Daz, allegedly, for a team 40. They had a team fucking 40. How stupid can you be? A team 40, do you know what I mean?
I should do that. What other team would do that?
I know. Can't you think?
So, it's going to be an interesting few days for them, but I would suggest that the whole squad will have to self-isolate and we'll end up, you know, at best case scenario is we play the coaching staff. That'd be a fucking laugh, but I don't know if they'd get registered quickly enough.
Hang on, I was against theirs. Oh fucking hell, man. Yeah.
You just put Gerrard out, wouldn't you?
just him and McAllister.
Some media outlet actually got mixed up the night and said that McAllister came on.
I seen that, aye.
that's how much we're taking the piss this year. We're bringing on Gary Mack.
Disrespectful Rangers. Open up the fucking poo hatch.
Shakira's hot as.
Agreed, John McLeish. Very much so.
See, next time we'll just fuck Zingo, right? And we'll just put the video on it, that tune.
That'll do.
Derek, how do you see it going, mate, on Sunday? Obviously, as I said before, the day traditionally gives a tough game up there. I once worked in Dundee, right, and the guy I worked with, a Spark up there, who was a Dundee United fan, and he says to me, now this was in 2013, 2014, and he says to me that actually we must hate Dundee United, we must hate Tannadice, and I informed him that actually I've got a soft spot for Tannadice because I've seen my team win more league championships on their ground than they have. So he didn't really take too well at that, actually. He never actually spoke to me again in the job, but hey, fuck him. Hope we pump his team on Sunday, you know, mate?
I think if the game's on, then I can see Rangers winning. I mean, Dundee United, Mickey Mellon's done an okay job in there. I was told behind the scenes things weren't too rosy a few weeks ago with the players and the coaching staff not getting on and things like that. But he seems to be getting a tune out the players that he's got at his disposal. That being said, Rangers should have too much for them. But again, like Ross County, they went up there, done the job, and get back down the road. They need to have their heads in the right place, go up there, respect him. I'm sure Gerard, you'll come out with this at the pre-match press conference and all that. They'll respect him and all that sort of stuff, but they'll go up there and they'll get the business done, I think, and come back down the road.
I think so. And then that's us, as I say, 16 clear, with obviously a couple of hours before they then take to the park. So again, it's transferring that pressure back to them.
Yeah.
Hopefully, by the time it's another Super Sunday for us, and we can celebrate again.
And I think, as you say, it's important that we do the business, apply the pressure, keep the pressure on.
Yeah.
Because psychologically, they're not handling this at all well. So, yeah. And I think, I agree with my good learned friend, Mr. Snags, down here. It's going to be 3-0 to us. We'll either win 3-0 in the park, or if they can't field the team, we get 3-0 off. So 3-0 victory either way.
And a weird way would be good if the game is called off and they get the 3-0 win just to see the aftermath of that. I mean, it'd be quite fun.
Or shits and giggles, yeah.
Aye, sorry for you, Derek, that can stay down south, you know what I mean? You and Snags. Me and Paul's going to live in amongst that. Right? That's fucking chaos, man, when that happens.
You have no idea of the absolute carnage that's going on up here. I mean, honestly, it's just they're losing the plot. It's really funny.
It's really funny. Moving on, I think we've discussed the FIPA, so we're going to talk a wee bit about this Coleman Streetwear thing, this partnership, which I don't know if you saw last week, Snagsy, but Baz asked people coming up to Christmas and that, what should they do with their money? And Baz went into a QVC style advert to buy some pod merch on copemanstreetwear.co.uk and ended it by condoning shoplifting. He says, if you're going down to shoplift, put your hoodie on, put your Battlefield hoodie on.
Riddle me this, how does one shoplift from an online shop?
Well, I don't know if he meant maybe if you were putting on to go to like the wee shops down the road and just aye, take what you want, you know, and put your hood up and I don't know, but you condone shoplifting anyway, and a few people were on Twitter after it and couldn't believe they'd actually say that. In fact, I told Chris for Coleman Streetwear, go and watch it because it's hilarious.
He's some man, that boy.
His backpedaling was quite funny, wasn't it, Paul?
it was typical Baz, hilarious and just hilarious, you know. He's just a bit off in a typical Baz rant. He is a wordsmith, shall we say?
Yes, and his wee video after it was good and all again. Wee Mo says, I went to Tannadice in a work matter, met Brian Grant. I told him I had happy memories of the place and it was good to be back. He asked, are you a fan? I was here when we got the night we got 9 in a row. He didn't smile.
I hope you fist bumped him anyway. Thanks for the memories, dickhead.
Aldo's got a question for his guys, and if there's any questions you want to add in, then go for it. Do you think that when we win on the 2nd of January, do you think it's game over? Because I do.
It's never game over, my friend. It's never game over.
It's not over to the fat lady sings, but if we continue our form and win every match until the 2nd of January, and then we do win on the 2nd of January, the fat lady's still not singing. However, she's in the wings warming up.
Aye, she's doing the vocal exercises to speak. Kenny DM'd me a jumper. Scott, did you order that Hulk Hogan hoodie I sent you? I didn't, mate, but that's going to be ordered. And when it comes, it's going on for a pod.
Excellent.
It's tremendous. Job. It's absolutely excellent. Tremendous. Paul had a protest at the amount of times we spoke about Hulk Hogan last week, and it was quite, actually hurt me, Paul, to be quite honest with you. no, not this again. No, I'm not saying it tonight. I can't.
Says the guy that fucking repeats everybody else's pattern, mate. Do you know what I mean? Fucking hell, he's got a cheek, isn't he? Do you know what I mean? You wear that hoodie, mate, and you wear it with fucking pride. Don't you listen to that old fucker up there. He'll be shelling his prawns anyway.
I can't believe Snags did this. I'll tell you what, Snags is part of, I told him this thing about castles, and he's taking us on here.
You started that policies, the battering rams, did you? Aye.
Barney, don't even try it.
He doesn't want to go there.
What is this about Hulk Hogan? I can't say every week, Barney. I never do that. I never talk about it, mate. I'm quite, you know, I never ever want to talk about it. Covercbeer.co.uk, go and buy some pod merch, guys, and you are putting money back into our football club, back into the Rangers Youth Development Company. We had a few people last week live on the pod tell us that they had bought, since we'd obviously spoke about it, they had bought the pod merch then, and I thank you so much for that, because as I say, you're helping Rangers out, and we spoke about some of the younger guys earlier who are breaking through this season, and that's playing a part in that and the future after that as well, you know, the next generation that's coming through. And hopefully we've got loads of young Rangers supporters on the park winning titles and trophies.
Two on the bench tonight.
Correct.
Dixon and Kinnear, both on the bench this evening for the European match. And it's your money that's doing that. Our money that's doing that. Just do it.
Praise lad.
Thanks, nice.
Maggie, enough. Bob, stop it.
We will all fall out here.
Stop it. Blood Angels, who else to Scott West? Right, speaking of live on a podcast, next week I'm hoping that we have Mr. Gregory Vignal join us on the podcast. Hopefully, Gregory is a coach at Marseille, and he's trying to work his diary run it to join us. So if he can, he will. If he can, he might get somebody else. We've got one coming with Stephen Smith as well. I believe it was supposed to be next year, but we might bring that one forward if Gregory can't make it. I'm not sure yet. So should be good next week. We should have a wee guest to round us off for Christmas. I think that'll be, won't it?
Beautiful. Can I just point out to the viewers and listeners that Greg actually watches this podcast as much as he possibly can, and he gets involved in the chat. So if you see and Pair's got Greg Vignal popping up, interact with him because he's always watching.
Aye. I done the post-match pod with Gregory Vignal after the Lyon game in the summer, and he done it in he done the pod from the front seat of his mate's car driving away from the game back into the city. Amazing. What a man he is, I'm telling you. And we did try and get him to come on the Helicopter Sunday pod as well, but he was just too busy, we couldn't make it work. Plus, he never played on that day, of course, because that's how fucked up we were back then. Don't know. Anyway, anything else we're wanting to mention, guys? Anything else you're wanting to bring up? Anything what MD's want to say?
I found out that Aris again for.
Yes,
I mentioned it. It's a Milevich art update. I'm sure that. Oh, you can't really see that, really, can you?
You just hold it for a few seconds.
Milevich art.
Milevich art. There you go, Vimo.
So you want to paint in a loud drop, that's the person you want to contact. Or any player.
Yes, get on that, by the way, because that is a beauty of Brian Laudrup.
Did you say she's Polish and she lives in Lark Hall?
No, she lives in Glasgow, but she is Polish, yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Bob says to us, I'll be in hospital over Christmas. Bob, all the best, mate. I'm home. Good luck. I'm sure you'll be out quick as me, and that'll be you back to speedy recovery and all that stuff.
Absolutely.
We're thinking of you, bro.
Absolutely.
Yes, mate.
You look after yourself, Bob.
Remember, we're always in the Twitter accounts, mate. You can talk to us there, so
and even that, if you even just want to DM one of us just to let us know how things are going, or just a chat,
yes, mate.
Please do so. You shouldn't be in hospital for Christmas alone. Give us a wee shout.
Yes, mate, definitely. BCID says, thank you for that. Maya Vinch Art. All right, you'll get a Brian Laudrup poster. I don't know if you'll get any work done with CID. I don't know if you'll get to go anywhere. You'll just be sitting staring at this painting of God on the wall. So I don't know if it's a good idea that you get that, to be fair. Stephen says, great podcast host. Well, listen, we're all the one team here. We're all the same team, and we all need to look after each other. So Bob says he'll have Twitter installed on his phone before he goes in. Good, mate. Good. Yeah, good, all the DMs are open, mate, and you can message us, because as Paul says, we don't want MD alone over Christmas. Anything else, guys? Are we just going to wrap things up? Did we get predictions? We did. Derek, did you give us a prediction for Sunday?
No, I think you all fancy 3-0, don't you? But I think I can't see United scoring against Rangers. I'll go 4-0. Another 4-0.
I'm with you, mate. 4-0. I want 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, whatever they can give us, but it's good he's mayor and mayor, because I want them fucking buried up there.
I love seeing tears, absolute tears. Oh,
beautiful, yeah. Wasn't it? Kenny, stop it. Stop it. Morag Station. Stop it. No. That's not right. That isn't right. I don't know. I think if we can get Gregory on next week, guys, and we'll maybe do a wee bear station again. For if MD wants to contact the pod, you don't need to come on if you don't want it. You can just DM the pod a question or tweet us a question, whatever. If you do want to come on, we'll send you a link and you can come on. Make a point, ask Gregory and Derek, Paul, Snags, whoever else is going to be here. A wee question. Yes, Paul, sorry.
I was going to say, and if you do decide to do that, we'd love you to come on, obviously, and put your point across either vocally or by audio, sorry, or by video. If you don't want your face to be seen, you can just do it by audio. You can
sing it.
Yeah, basically, sing it. You can appear on screen pretty much as Derek did at the start. You know, the camera's not working. So you can do that. This podcast is nothing without people that watch it. And the more you get involved, the more important it is to us. Because we do it for fun, and we do it for you guys as well. And if you can get interacted, get involved, it means a great deal to us.
Yes. You don't need to underthink anything on this pod.
Stop it.
All you need to do is hashtag embrace the madness, as Baz says a couple of weeks ago. Anyway, done. Anything else anybody wants to say? No. Be done. Finished. Quality.
Obviously, if you're buying Christmas presents, look up My Friend Catfish on Amazon. It's a fantastic book by a very good friend of mine, Maggie Payton, about her experiences with a stalker who's probably in the chat on about 5 accounts just now. So definitely get it on the list. It's a fantastic read and frightening at the same time. But please buy it. Amazon, all good bookstores. Paul Sees has got a copy right there, I'm sure, to show you all.
I've got 2 seconds. Go back. Keep it talking.
All right. Oh no, he's got his other book. He's got his other book.
We'll just keep going.
So look at him in his bookshelf.
No, he's a QVC.
Moving the langoustines out the way. Like, where's that fucking book? Get out of the way, you mad lobster.
2 seconds. I'm old. I'm old. I've broken back. So there's
good
Maggie's,
lad.
There's Maggie's book.
Get it.
It's amazing.
Get off Amazon.
And also, let's not forget another pod contributor. This one as well.
Thomas Simpson,
who's also got
legend.
His new one coming out soon.
He has. Yeah. He has. I may or may not be proofreading it right now.
Two great books. This is a horror novella, and it is honestly really, really, really good. I'm not just saying that because it's Simmy. It's really, really good.
He likes it, Derek, because it says something about a handsome guy called Paul in it.
That's
why he likes it, mate.
Who eventually gets stabbed.
Paul for work was handsome and witty, and all the ladies liked him. And I read that line out on flying across on holiday, and I read that line out and I burst out laughing. And I showed my wife in the plane, and she went, "Yeah, Sammy always was good with fiction."
Paul was last seen drowning in caviar. Get to fuck your posh bastard.
That was a Naomi slap down. I love it. Yes, get any 2 books, guys, especially with Christmas coming up. Let's face it, we're helping out to our own as well, and that's the beauty of it. You know, that's the beauty of it. So, yes. When does Simmy's new book hit the shelves? That might be one for Snags.
It's probably going to be the new year, I would suspect, given it's being proofed right now. So keep your eyes peeled, and if you don't follow Simi already, he's at Simi41 on Twitter, and obviously you'll hear about it first on there. But if we get any exclusive news via the podcast, via someone else, or via the man himself, we will keep you posted.
He may be one of your guests. A famous talk about author book. To come on
exactly.
And talk about his book.
Exactly.
Fucking Jonathan Ross here, man. Jesus Christ.
Should have a green room. Well, no, a blue room even.
That was a good real-time correction there.
By the way, that happened to me in the pod with Mark Warburton as well. He says, green shoots are recovery. I mean blue shoots are recovery. He says, don't worry, Mark, you'll learn fate and go again. plan B is today, plan A better, remember.
Oh dear.
Thank you very much to everybody for joining us tonight, and also our pre-match pod that we pre-recorded in a flash at lunchtime.
and they get hundreds and hundreds of views. We were really, really, for such a short time, it was amazing. So thank you all for watching that.
It's absolutely mad to think that it only went out a few hours before the game, mate, and then it's sitting at 2020 views on YouTube. It's mad, isn't it, really, to think that and how quick it goes, especially when we got it so spectacularly wrong. How many people know that now? It's quite done. But
line
anyway,
up,
that's...
What was the lineup? We were all spot on with the result, but lineup we got completely wrong.
It's worth watching that podcast just to see Scott go to policies. How do you think Steven Gerrard will change the team? And Paul going, I don't know.
No, and then I says, do you think maybe we'll bring McLaughlin in? And everybody's like, we're all out.
Nah, fuck off. No chance. Consistency, mate. Fuck off.
Tav Gold's in there, a stick on. Tav's with the team for the first time ever.
Yeah, he said one thing, and that's Zungu. He might bring Haji in. Nah, nothing else apart from that.
But hey, what do we know? What do we know? Hey, thanks very much to everybody for tuning in. My thanks to Paul, to Snagsy, and of course to Derek Clark. Now, Derek, maybe before we do go, we should say Derek's going to do a couple of wee blogs and stuff like that for us to go on the website, because I've let it die a death recently. So I really need to get back into that. So Derek's going to do a few of them as and when we can, and they'll be uploaded whenever he gets around there, because he's a busy, busy man. So thanks very much for that, mate. Seriously, that's much appreciated.
No problem.
Much appreciated. Fantastic. Paul, you want to say what you say before a Rangers game?
Thanks so much for watching today, and I hope your team wins.
Hashtag keep the bat fever on.